Hi everyone, let's analyze Phenotex Chemicals. So this is a chemical company. What do we have here? The usual up from the March low, around 500% or so. There was this base here, it broke out. Very good, run up from here. And then it sort of based out from here and it broke out. So if you see, this whole correction has been on extremely low volume, and then it caught traction from here and then it broke out. So what was the trade? So basically, the moment it sort of gapped up and sort of was consolidating here, I've been buying at these levels somewhere over here as well. So, you know, my cost price is at around 70, 71, and it is up 20%. But I think that this can sort of, I was hoping that this sort of comes down a little bit and then I could add more, but that's not happening. So I will try and add more position over here, because, you know, overall this price action looks very good. On a week on week basis, if you see, it's gone up on higher volume and then it's consolidating further. So I think that we can consolidate further and then break out from here. However, in an eventuality, if this sort of breakdowns come still here, I will be a buyer. So I think that may happen, because, you know, now if you see, down days are on higher volume. So it can happen. I'm not sure if it may not. But if it consolidates here and breaks out further, I will be adding on to my position. So what happened, if you see, this went quickly up and then it consolidated. And if you see, the whole correction was on very, very low volume, very low volume. And then suddenly you see a spike. So you see a spike, and that's where I got interested. So the moment it sort of reclaimed 50 and then there was a spike in volume going up, that got me interested. So I usually wait for it to sort of consolidate a bit and then buy. So the moment it sort of went down and came up again, I was buying at these levels. I've bought here, added here. So my, you know, average price is around 70 or so. It's doing pretty well, around 18-20%. But to be honest with you, I don't really enjoy a 15-18% pop. So my stop loss was 15-16%. So I am looking at least at a 35-40% return, you know, minimum, 1:2, 1:3. So that's the technical front. Let's look at it's a microcap company, specialty chemical. So if you see, good amount of holdings with DIIs and promoters, you know, that's a good sign. 36 crores of cash flow. Don't have any loan. They have 32 crores worth of investments cash on the balance sheet. And what's the most encouraging thing is that sales have been continuously rising, margins have been great, and their profits have also risen. Overall, it is showing highest profits over here, and profits have doubled since the past 2-3 years. So these numbers are extremely encouraging. If you look at the March numbers also, March number, very great. Traction was built up since September. You know, see, if you see, September results were higher, then December results were higher. So the traction was already building up, you know. So stock is at a very good place fundamentally. And I'll be buying on dips. So if it dips further, I'll be adding more to my position, you know, if it dips further from here. Looks a bit likely, because, you know, if you see, it's this is another stock I'm holding, DY and Pro. We'll do an analysis of this also soon. It's a food chemical company. So it's pretty far off from the 200 day right now. So I'm hoping that it consolidates, pulls back a bit. That'll be great, you know. So let's see if that happens. Okay, thanks a lot, guys.